Welcome back. So yes, we're going to talk about fourth place as Manchester City. Now they're in fourth with 42 points. Now City, they had a good start, but inconsistency. We saw the regret, you could say, of Yaya Toure back in the squad. But City, they look toothless. They don't have that sting anymore. So what do you think about City's chances?
Again, you're bang on point. Pep started off really well, like we said in the preview before this year. And this, statistically, if your fans want to look it up, has been his worst start to a league season. Firstly with Barcelona, then with Bayern Munich. Mm-hmm. This is the fewest amount of points he's ever collected in a league. And they have the best squad. They have the best wages. Mm-hmm. They have everything. They have the best manager in the world. Mm-hmm. But they seem to be slipping. And what we discussed, this is when Pep will really start to prove his mettle against the West Broms of this world, the West Hams, the Watfords, the Bournemouths, you know. Yeah. This is when he really has to prove his mettle. I watched the Hull City game, and really and truly, they won. I believe Iheanacho scored, somebody else scored. But City were never in control. Yeah. I never believed they would have won the game. Yeah. But you have to think that they have the additional quality to be there, thereabouts. Yeah. At the top four.
Yeah.
But with their squad, I think they should have been where Chelsea is.
That's true.
They should have been going. But then again, there's so many question marks over the City squad too. But forget Pep for a minute. We're looking at the City squad. Claudio Bravo has come into the side. I don't believe he settled any more than Lourdes Karius.
That's true.
And I don't know why the media hasn't picked up on that, but Gary Neville has picked up on Lourdes Karius. We all know why. Mm-hmm. But Claudio Bravo, nobody says anything.
And
Vincent Kompany hasn't been fit for the longest while.
What's new?
This boy, Kolarov, is playing as a centre-back, which is confusing.
It's true.
So, I mean, Pep really needs to iron out some things. You have to admit, they have the money, they have the quality to be at the top four.
That's true.
But I mean, at the business end of the season, I'm sure they'll be there or thereabouts.
Yeah. I think it's guaranteed they should finish top four, but I mean, with defeats to Spurs, to Leicester, to Liverpool, to Chelsea, the big games where you think they would come out, they aren't. And then in the small games, there are a lot of draws taking place, and that's just going to...
No, but Josh, if you look at it, if that was a United manager, he would be... If that was a United or Liverpool manager, he'd be under so much pressure.
With his Pep. And I think the one thing with the media, I believe a lot of the media are afraid of Pep. Now, as it pertains to how recent times with Pep, you could see the media is getting under his skin now.
Yeah,
because
the media
the
is getting
pressure
under
that it brings, you could see
that's
he's
what
actually
we said
falling
in the preview.
Apart.
The media in England is different. Yep. And this is what I'm saying. The scrutiny Pep is going to be under. If Pep was a Liverpool or United manager, even a Chelsea manager, he would be under a lot of scrutiny. That's the reality of it.
Yeah. So moving on to fifth place. A strange club, you could say, that's in fifth. We normally see them in fourth, Arsenal. I know a lot of the Arsenal fans suffering with ACS, Arsenal choking syndrome. We normally see it at the start of January, but it started in December this year. So Arsenal not having a good end to the campaign, well, to the end of the year, I should say. Yeah. And it looks as though it's the same old, same old. I think if you check back all the episodes of Football 1-1, when we talk about Arsenal, we could literally repeat stuff from 3 years ago because it's the same thing. Yeah. Every single year.
And we said this the last time, Joshua. Arsenal, they go on a nice winning run. They win 7-8 games. They put a nice run together. When they start to look like title challengers, guess what? They lose.
Yep.
It explodes. They draw. They drop points. And everything like that happens. Mm-hmm. However, he maintains his fourth place.
Yeah.
You know, I said just now, I think all those teams should be there or thereabouts. That meaning Arsenal is in fifth.
Mm-hmm.
So this year, it's a fight for that four, you know. So I think Arsene Wenger squad, he has the experience and they have the quality to get a top four place as well.
True.
However, and this is where it gets tricky. You have to decide when a player is going to become a disruptive force or more than he is a creative force.
Yeah.
Alexis Sanchez at the end of their game with, I believe it was Bournemouth, the 3-3. He was shouting, he was throwing his gloves, he was upset, you know. And I realized that he is miles and miles ahead of the other Arsenal players.
It's true, because if you're a striker, Yes, you score the goal to tie it up at 3-3. I'm talking about Olivier Giroud. Mm-hmm. But to me, you have 20 minutes left in the game. You don't go and celebrate. You pick up the ball and you go back to the middle of the field. If it's in the 90th minute or something and you get the equalizer, no problem. But like, you could understand what Alexis, you could feel for him there.
Yeah, but I mean, Giroud scored late on in the game and he did the Scorpion celebration. And for me, United, Manchester United, I keep going back to it.
You always
that
go back
game,
to every club.
That game would have been won if it was Manchester United in the old days.
Yeah.
And that's the mark of a champion. And I still find that Arsene Wenger, all Arsenal fans, I know a lot of people want Wenger out. Sometimes they bring the banners to the club. This may be his last year. Let him give it a crack and try. But I could feel your pain because every year it's the same thing, the same way, the same story that we reach up there. And we just fall back down to fourth. Or you have a false finish in second, like last year.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, I mean, I could feel for them. They have the squad, though, which is funny.
Yes, it's
but,
hard.
But look at this. People don't look at this. Mustafi was out with a hamstring injury. And they go to play Bournemouth. They have a lot of games, right? Gabriel hasn't played this year, right? He takes Mustafi straight off of the hamstring, puts him in, pulls out Gabriel, who has been blooded already, who in there for the past couple of games. They're 3-0 down, right? No, but I'm just saying, if he left Gabriel in, the Arsenal fans would have said, he should have played Mustafi.
Exactly. Say, so, damn if you do, you damn if you don't.
Yeah, so with Arsene Wenger, it's like, that's how it is right now. They're at a point where, but kudos to Giroud. He's been fantastic the past couple of games. For any fantasy Premier League people out there, he's a fantastic pickup. Assists, he scores right now.
True.
And Perez is even doing, he scored a wonder goal recently.
Yeah.
But Sanchez, to me, has really been the crown jewel in that team.
Yeah, it's true. Well, we have 3 minutes left in this segment, and the last 3 minutes will belong to the sixth place Manchester United, who have 39 points. Now, United have had a really great end of the year. It's their best run since, I believe, 2013, with, 6 consecutive wins in the EPL, 8 wins on the bounce in all competition. So, well done to United. Well done to them finally getting some form. Ooh. And that fear factor is somewhat coming back to Old Trafford, you could say. Especially when Liverpool meet them this coming Sunday.
No? I know normally we do shows top 4, top 5. I find it was weird when we had to do top 6.
Well, they're what, only 10 points off of the first place? That's what, 3 games and a draw.
People will do, next year we'll do top 7 for you, Josh.
No.
No, but at the end of the day, kudos to United. Mourinho has done well, he's turned it around. They're doing pretty well. As I said before with you again, it will happen. Pogba just needed time to settle. Zlatan is doing well. The biggest problem in the team was Wayne Rooney. He's out. That's a big one. Mkhitaryan has come in. He's chipped in. He's done well.
Yeah.
He's found a formula at the back. Your player of the year, season upon season, David De Gea.
Yes.
He will obviously do well for Manchester United. But when a goalkeeper is always player of the year, as Mourinho said, something is wrong.
Something is wrong.
So,
yes.
I mean, United has done well in the past few games. My worry always with United, and not only United, but more extension of United, Mourinho, is when things start to go bad, how will he react?
That's
and
true.
His reaction plays down to players. And we have to play them. I mean, Liverpool has to play them coming up. That's a big game, Klopp versus Mourinho, really, at Old Trafford. If that game turns sour, I don't know what's the other run of games for United.
Well, we have a somewhat easy fixture coming up in January.
Okay, so I mean, you had to look at it. But I don't see United cracking the top 4, but I see them being there about. Just I honestly, I think the top 6 are going to be separated by 1 or 2 points.
Yeah, it's true. So let me hear your predictions for top 4.
This is a totally different ball game, and you have to understand that why. Because nobody expected. I think we were bang on with everything but the Chelsea.
Yeah.
Nobody expected Antonio Conte to turn this around. Chelsea has been pretty good, but I think an injury to Diego Costa might be. I had to think about it for a minute. I'm kind of glad Liverpool is in second because the pressure is off us for a minute. City is strong, no matter what. You know, you can't, you know. So it's really, I hate to sit on the fence, but I see it to stand as Chelsea, Liverpool, Tottenham, as it is now.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this is the year that Arsenal miss out the Champions League.
Yeah.
I think it's City.
And the amount of times I heard that for the start of the season, that this is the Arsenal may miss out.
Yeah, but if they miss out, it's either that's the top four. I can't put it in any order. I don't know at this point because it's really been a topsy-turvy year. Nobody expected Chelsea to be this bad. This good. Nobody expected Liverpool. I know nobody expected Liverpool to be this good.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really a topsy-turvy year. We have to see how City respond.
Mm-hmm.
And Josh, we can't make a prediction now because today's January, City, Chelsea, and United have deep pockets.
I just want to see if you would have bring United in the top four, and well, you didn't. So no. It didn't really matter.
No, but they have deep pockets, and they could go into the market and change the whole game. We know that. So it's another thing there, too, where Chelsea could go in and buy. If Chelsea buys another striker,
mm-hmm.
they walk the league.
Yeah, that's true.
But, we'd have to see how it goes.